Hey guys, in this video I'm going to show you how I make my DIY envelope, which I use to package my stickers, and I use it as a replacement for a plastic sleeve. The great thing about this is I can fit multiple stickers in here, including like vinyl stickers or stuff, and it just looks really cute because it's semi-transparent. I use vellum paper, and it's a great way to keep all my stickers organized when they go out in the mail. And bonus, it's also a great reusable sleeve if anyone decides to use this in their planner to store their own stickers. So obviously you can make this whatever size you want. I just made this to fit my sticker sheets perfectly. I'll give you the specific measurements later, but this is just to show you how I slotted in. I chose to do it a top flap just because I think it's cuter, but really this design could be used to make a flap in any direction, whichever one you prefer. And now onto the tutorial. So what you'll need is a pair of scissors, nothing fancy, a glue stick or whatever form of adhesive you want to use, some vellum paper, of course, some scrap paper to make your template, a pen to draw your template, and optionally you can use a corner cutter if you're feeling fancy. This is completely optional because it works still really well with like square corners, but if you want to make it a little bit more aesthetic, you can use a corner cutter to get those rounded corners. So grab whatever you want to put into your envelope and basically just measure out the size of it using the scrap paper. There's kind of four parts to this. So you have the top flap, the bigger side flap that folds across all of it, and then you have the smaller side flap, and then the bottom flap. So the order that you do these depend on you, but I tend to fold from the right first, then the bigger flap, and then the bottom flap last. The order doesn't really matter. I originally wanted the bottom flap to fold up first, but then I thought it looked better and a bit more secure if I folded it up last. I also forgot to mention that you'll need a ruler to measure whatever it is you want to put inside your envelope. So here I'm just measuring the width of it, which is about 11, and then also the height of it. So you don't want your envelope to be exactly the same width and height because you want there to be some wiggle room, and also if you want to stack extra sticker sheets inside, so just keep that in mind. Now I'm just lining it up on the scrap paper and measuring how far across I actually want it, but also adding an extra gap for the flap that I fold over. So I only left 1.5 centimeters for the flap, but that turned out to be too small. So I would add probably about 2.5 at least. 3 if you're feeling a little crazy, but yeah. 2 or 2.5 should be enough. Mark all your measurements down onto the scrap paper template and make sure you write down the right number, not like me here. So my sticker sheet was about 11 centimeters wide, and I just added 1 centimeter, I think, here. Yeah, 1 centimeter, just to add some wiggle room. And then don't forget to leave room for your flap, which should be at least 2 centimeters. So now we do the same thing, but for the height of your envelope. So now I'm just making measurements for the top flap, the middle part, and the bottom flap. So I left again 1.5 centimeters, but I recommend something more, like 2. So for the big flap that folds over, we want it to be the same width as the other side of the envelope because we want it to fold over nicely. So that part should be 12 centimeters as well. So I just made that marking there, and then I just added up all those measurements and then wrote down the total length. Now that I've pretty much got the measurements for everything, I'm just gonna line everything up, draw the lines, connect all these lines so that I know exactly how long, how tall things are, and where to cut it. So I'm just cutting up the template now once I've got my measurements done. I'm just doing it with scissors. You could use a paper trimmer if you wanted to be more precise, but I didn't include that in the list of things that you'll need because not everyone has a paper trimmer, and I just want to show that it's possible to make this with just scissors, with basic tools. Hang in there guys, we are almost there. I'm making some additional markings so I know where to fold it, I know where everything should be folded and where everything should be cut. So I'm mostly just making markings for the flaps and that center line. And voila, this is your template. It's pretty messy, but once you start to cut out the pieces that you don't need, it'll make more sense. So you only need the top flaps and then you can cut it off the ends. So I'm cutting out the bottom part here because it's part of the bottom flap, but we don't need the flap to be the entire length of it because we're just folding this part over. And since the bottom flap is folding up, it'll just fold on top of that, if that makes sense. That didn't really make sense. Okay, just watch what I'm doing. Just cut out these top and bottom flaps on your big flap. And then the same thing on the other side. Now we have those corners that we don't need, so we snip them off so that we end up with three separate flaps, the top, the bottom, and the side. Hopefully it's starting to make a bit more sense now because I know I did a terrible job of explaining it, but as you can see, I'm just folding up the flaps here, doing also a very terrible job at folding the flaps because I'm not very accurate and I find it very hard to fold straight lines. If you're feeling fancy, this is the time where you pull out your corner cutter and cut those corners. It's a little tricky because you kind of have to fold the flaps down as you push it into the corner cutter and do it. It doesn't always work. It depends if your lines are straight or not, which mine aren't always. But yeah, I just like adding this extra little touch because it looks, I don't know, a little bit more refined. So because I was lazy, I didn't actually make one on camera, but I'm just going to show you how to go from this template and make your own. So basically take your glue stick, and I'm going to pretend to glue here. You glue that flap first on the right. You fold down the big flap. You make sure they're stuck nice together, folded nice and flat. Glue the bottom flap, fold it up. Pretty simple, right? And then there's your envelope. That's basically it. And then the top flap, obviously you don't glue down, otherwise you don't have an envelope anymore. But then I secure it using washi tape or something like that. I should probably clarify that I mean you're supposed to keep your template for the measurements and the correct shape of it. Don't actually glue down your template. Use the vellum paper to recreate it. And here's one I prepared earlier. And I even made a small little envelope, similar design, a little bit different, for my little vinyl stickers, and I think they're so cute. I made it with a slightly thinner vellum paper, which you can tell here is a little bit flimsier, but it's still quite good for putting the stickers in. I don't think it needs to be super strong, and it is quite a lot cheaper to use the thinner one. So here I have the two different thicknesses of the vellum paper that I used. So this one is 70 GSM, as you can tell, pretty flimsy, right? And the one on the right is 113 GSM, to be really specific. The thicker one is obviously a little bit more expensive, but the quality is a lot nicer. And I think I'll just use the thicker one if people are buying multiple sticker sheets because it is quite sturdy, and the thinner one just for one or two sticker sheets. But I will link those both below. I just got these off AliExpress. They're quite cheap. It's not too expensive to get, but really you could also just use normal paper or any other colored paper. Vellum is just one type of paper that I like to use because I think it looks really nice with the stickers. So here is the exact template I used for the other one, not the one I just created. That was not very good. The numbers are a little weird. I would recommend adjusting them because I don't think I even made the big flap the same as the other side. So not super accurate, but just pause the screen and have a look at it. And this is my little tiny one that I use for the vinyl sticker, if you're interested. Again, these values are not the hard limit. You can change it to whatever you want. If you're interested, please leave a comment. I might make a digital template of this if that's easier, and you could try using a Cricut machine to cut it out. I haven't actually tried it yet, but I probably should. But if I do get around to doing that, you'll see it in the studio vlog. So thank you so much for watching. Please let me know if I messed up in any part or anything was confusing, because I probably made a mistake. Bye.